Hi everyone! So I decided to make a favorites video on this Easter Sunday. It's sort of the lull of late afternoon, and I just returned from a stroll around the village in Manhattan, which I never go there anymore. So it was really cool. It was like I was going back in time, and Evan and I tried to reenact a photo that we took on 6th Avenue looking up towards this old church. There's an old photo of me from 2006 and I'm in profile, and we tried to recreate it. So we were somewhat successful. But anyway, we were walking home, and then this like sun shower just came from out of nowhere, and it was really, there's a very strange energy in the air. And anyway, I have like this time to fill with whatever I want for the next couple of hours, so I thought I would talk to you guys. I'm mostly going to be talking about hair and skin care products, not so much makeup, and a few other things, like this hat. This hat. I got this when I visited my parents towards the end of March down south. My dad had it hanging on his wall, and I was like, ooh, cool hat. He said, well, you want it? He said he got it from a yard sale for $2. So anyway, it's worth a lot more than $2. It's a packable, water-repellent, light felt, 100% wool hat by Bailey. I understand that they're a well-known hat maker. Their stuff's pretty expensive. I looked online, I couldn't find this exact model, but similar hats were like $170, and then the light felt hats, I guess this would be from that line, were slightly more affordable. But this style, which is sort of a Western style, yet they had some on around the $170 range that were called fedoras, though they didn't look like fedoras. They were this size. Anyway, cool hat. I've gotten lots of compliments on it. I just love wearing it. I love wearing it. Okay, so next up, let's go to hair. Okay, I have two hair products. Both are samples. I do not own full-size bottles of these yet. I don't know if I will, because Birchbox keeps sending me really great hair products to try. I know a lot of people aren't as big of fans of Birchbox as, say, Ipsy or Sephora Play, but I really like the skincare and hair care products, not so much the makeup. And that's why I have so many things to talk about from them. All right. The first would be this Beauty Protector. That's the brand. Can you see, or is it, it's too sunny in here, isn't it? There we go. Perhaps the label looks familiar. Beauty Protector, they have a very popular, comes in a red and black bottle. It says protect and detangle underneath their logo on the bottle, and it's like a leave-in conditioner type of thing. Very popular. It smells really good. It's like vanilla. This one is called Protect and Volume Spray. So it's great because it kind of gives your hair a lift while making it shinier, which is awesome because you think of like a leave-in conditioner as weighing down your hair, or a shine spray, or a hair gloss. Those things are usually very heavy, but this is so lightweight, and it has the same smell as the other Protect and Detangle thing. All right, so that's been fun. The next is Oribe Dry Texturizing Spray. This, I've never been too fond of dry shampoos for a few reasons. The biggest reason being that as a brunette, most of these things are, they're like, it's like talc, spray talc, and you spray it in your hair, and it's like, now I'm 70. My hair is gray wherever I spray it. And after working it in and maybe putting on a hat, it looks okay, but it's just it's way too much effort and waiting time to make it to make your hair color look as vibrant as it normally does. So I have quite a few, again, from Birchbox. They send tons of samples of this stuff, some very high-end ones that aren't supposed to make your hair gray. But anyway, this doesn't put powder in your hair. It's like a, I don't know. It's like, let's just try. I'll show you. Okay. All right. So you go in like that. Probably used too much just now because I can't really see what I'm doing. And it will make your hair more volumized, and it gives it texture. If your hair is a little oily, my hair is pretty much always oily unless I've just washed it. It takes care of that. So it has the benefits of a dry shampoo, with it's like dry shampoo plus and minus the whiteness. All right, so on to some skincare products. I think this is also a Birchbox sample. Hustle Butter Luxe. They call it a multi-purpose cream, and it really is multi-purpose. It's kind of the texture is very almost no, I wouldn't say it's waxy. Maybe close to being waxy though, because it's almost solid. And I can't remember the main ingredients of this stuff, but I have used this on wounds, and they heal extremely rapidly. And then this was so impressive. I burned my thumb and forefinger. I microwaved something on a plate that was not microwave safe, because how do you know what's microwave safe and what isn't? But well, here's how you know. You trial and error. You microwave whatever you're trying to heat up on a plate, and when you go to take it out, it's like a million degrees. So the burn on my forefinger wasn't so bad, but my thumb was just charred, basically, and it looked really pruney, like if you've been in a hot bath for too long. It was all shriveled up. So, and it hurt like hell, all right? I put some of this stuff on my thumb shortly after burning it, and it was like the burn never happened. I'm not making this up, I'm not exaggerating. It didn't even take very long for it to work. But it helped with the pain within a few hours. It wasn't hurting that much, you know, unless I pressed it against something that was of an extreme temperature, either too hot or too cold. But my skin never peeled. The puckered effect went away. It's just amazing stuff, amazing stuff. And I've used it also on like zits that I've picked at that leave a red mark. It's good at healing any type of open wound. So yeah, great stuff. I will definitely have to get some of that. A full size, I mean. Next, along the same lines, you've probably heard about the wonder that is snail slime. This is Multifunction Formula Snail Repair Intensive Ampoule, I guess, Ampoule by Mizon. I got this on Amazon. It was under $20, and I've actually had it a while. It's about half empty. It's about the size of a like hotel size bottle of Grand Marnier. kind of looks the same. Anyway, I use Retin-A most nights, but a couple times a week, right after I do an acid mask, which I use a papaya enzyme mask. It's not very expensive by Oh God, the brand. Okay, flaking on the name of the brand. I'm not even talking about that in this video. It's not one of my favorites for the spring. That's like favorite from 10 years ago that I still use. Anyway, so right after I do my exfoliation with the acid, I put this on my face and I sleep in it. Sometimes I wear it in the daytime, and anyway, it vastly and very quickly improves your skin texture. This is also, it's like it keeps zits away somehow. I have no idea how. But it makes my skin look really young, and it's as you would expect. I mean, if this is real snail slime and not just chemicals, that's what keeps the snails from having cuts, as they slink along on hard surfaces, abrasive surfaces. Their snail slime keeps everything together. So it's actually brilliant, and yet it should be kind of an obvious, skin benefiting item. Okay. The next thing is my favorite hand cream of all time, because it's so hard to find, not just hand cream that is fully absorbed into your skin. Like if you get Aquaphor or shea butter, it's like they just sit right on top of your skin, and that they might protect it, but they don't really heal the chapping. If you're like me and you're germphobe and you wash your hands about 200 times a day, every time you touch something, you really need something that's hardcore. But I also don't like my hands to feel greasy. So anyway, this is the best thing I've found that suits my needs. It's Burt's Bees Ultimate Care Hand Cream with Baobab Oil for very dry skin. Doesn't really have a fragrance, that's fine, even though I love fragrances. Usually the fragrant hand creams are exactly the ones that do nothing, Actually, Ipsy sent me one this month that is total crap. Seychelles by The White Company, which is supposed to smell like bergamot, amber, and vanilla. Can you see that? Okay, there. Yeah. I don't even like the smell. I don't like it. It smells like perfume that I would never buy, stuff that would give me a headache. But it does nothing. It's like you put it on, and you, like, right after you put it on, you can feel it. It's nice, and then it's gone. And then my hands need something like this, like the Burt's Bees. And this stuff is like, I think it's $12.99 or so for a bottle of this size, which is very pricey, in my opinion. But I have not found anything comparable. So check it out if you need to try a new hand cream. Next is a supplement that I've been taking, Adrenal Wellness by Dr. Danielle Saunders, Saunders. I will link this below. This is, well, designed to support your adrenal glands, but I had read that ashwagandha and rhodiola and schisandra berry are all, and ashwagandha, did I say that already? I probably did. Are all great adaptogens, good for your energy, your metabolism. Supporting muscle recovery in the case of the schisandra berry. And I turned to this because perhaps in a previous video you heard me talk about my downstairs neighbor who keeps me awake half the night, more than half the night. It's still going on. He's down there like banging, dropping bricks on the ground. I don't know what the hell he's doing. Slamming things, making all these percussive noises until 2 in the morning. And then I have these other people in the next building who are getting up at 4 and 5 in the morning. So I've got like from 2 until 4 o'clock most nights. And then I'll have a break of, a couple days a week, everything's fine, but the rest of the time it's not. So during the week, like getting 5 hours of sleep is now kind of the norm, and that's, I'm not a short sleeper or anything. I need 7 to 7.5 hours. Anyway, so I've been taking Benadryl to help me sleep, which is not good for a couple of reasons. Well, for a few reasons. First of all, it makes me feel groggy the entire rest of the day. It can make you put on weight. And I have chronic sinus issues. So if you take something that is designed to desiccate the contents of your sinuses, and you're prone to sinus infections, it's a pretty bad combo. So, because you get a sinus infection when your sinuses can't drain, right? So, anyway, I haven't been taking like the entire Benadryl when I do this, usually. Usually it's more like a third or a half, and I'm a lightweight and I'm very sensitive to drugs, so that usually gives me about 5 hours of sleep. When I started doing this back in December, I noticed after a couple of weeks of solid, like doing it every night, I gained a couple of pounds, and I'm not, I don't, I did not change my diet. I didn't do anything differently. Suddenly I gained 2 pounds. And it's, I was like, whoa, okay, I have to move out of this apartment because no one is going to have the power of changing my health or my body, especially not my body, my body shape. So, then I don't know, I thought about, what can I do to like counteract any negative effects on my metabolism that clearly this medicine is having? I did, research this online, and of course it can happen. It slows down everything. So the adaptogens and supporting your adrenal glands, it, kind of raises everything back to a normal level. And after I started taking this, it was like 2 pounds gone. And coincidence? I don't think so. I didn't change anything else. So yeah, so it's been a good supplement to take. I think it helps with my energy, at least a little bit. And let's see. The last thing I will talk about is a real treat. Clan of Xymox came out with a new album a couple of weeks ago, I think it was. And I downloaded the whole thing. It's called Days of Black. Perhaps you have heard the single. Perhaps you've heard the single Loneliness, which, hang on, trying to cue this up in my iTunes, and my iTunes are not cooperating with me. Here we go. If you haven't heard this yet, I'm just going to play it. I'm not going to get any money from this video. Not that I ever get more than like a penny, because I only have a few viewers, but this is probably one of the best crafted songs I've heard. Well, Ghost has had quite a few, but especially Square Hammer, it's very poppy, and it has like radio play crossover potential, in my opinion. This is so good. It's so good. It has jangly guitars. It's like old Clan of Xymox, yet it's timeless. So we're just gonna li band. It's a great song. There's a video for it out already too. It's so good, it's so good, it's so good. So as, I won't play the whole thing, but at least we'll get to the chorus. It's coming. The whole album is great. Alright, so get to downloading if you don't have it yet. Bye!